I'm here at Outlaws Boxing talking to boxing trainer, strength conditioning expert Brandon Krause. Brandon, Amir Khan coming off a sensational victory over Devin Alexander. He does an interview with the Express, the Daily Express in London, and he says, hey, I'm not going to do the same mistake I did in 2013, waiting 8 months for Floyd. If by mid-January, Floyd Mayweather doesn't come to negotiate, I'm moving on.
Good. I mean, waiting on Floyd turned out to be a kind of a short-term career folly for him. And, yeah, I doubt he wants to do that again. You know what? I would make whatever fight presents itself, because there is a big fight ahead of Amir Khan, whether it's Floyd or not. And he's coming off a win where he looked good, and he's back in the public's eye, and he's got some of that ring rust off him. Yeah, why don't you go do an all UK showdown with Kel Brook?
Who wins that one?
I don't know.
Okay, so Khan Brook is one option.
Yeah, or
80,000 fans.
Easy. Yeah, that'll be huge. How about Tim Bradley? You know,
Tim Bradley Khan.
How about
who wins that one?
Thurman Khan.
Thurman Bradley is a good one too.
There's many attractive fights out there for Amir
Ortiz,
Khan.
Ortiz, Victor Ortiz, Amir Khan.
Why not? I think that'll be the least attractive out of all the ones we're talking about, but sure.
Why not? What's wrong with that?
Because Victor Ortiz is still not really recovered from that knockout. Putting him in there with guys that he can beat right now, just to try to get his confidence back up. I think you're putting him in there too soon, put him in there against Amir Khan, somebody with the likes of Amir Khan. I think you got to give him another couple of tune-up fights to really start getting his confidence back.
Okay, how about this one? Amir Khan, Manny Pacquiao. They sparred, they know each other. It was very close sparring. They both dazed each other. No one went down, no one got dropped, but they both had speed.
Yeah, but that's sparring, Manny. You know, fighting Manny's a whole different guy. You know what I mean?
Amir Khan's a new fighter with Virgil Hunter.
New fighter, but with the same chin.
You know? Nah, he looked great this fight. He didn't even get touched.
He didn't look again. He fought
a southpaw.
He fought Devin Alexander, who doesn't knock people out.
But Alexander, he beat Matisse, he beat Maidana. He fought a very tough fighter.
He didn't knock him out.
I think people don't give Alexander enough credit. He fights the toughest dude.
Yeah, but again, it's
no easy fight.
The issue with Alexander is when it's a huge moment, he seems to not do enough. You know what I mean? It seems to always like happen to him when the moment is big, he doesn't do enough. But again, this is compare. You can't compare Devin Alexander to Manny Pacquiao.
Amir Khan, who fights at 47, Canelo at 54. If they meet at 50, 52, is that a good fight?
No, because Canelo knocks Amir out probably within 5 rounds.
You think so?
Yeah.
Okay, what about Cotto Khan?
Cotto Khan
at 47.
More interesting fight. That's actually somewhat of an interesting fight. I probably have to. That was a tough one to call. Because
too close to call?
Yeah, that's a
I got Amir Khan, easy work. Too fast.
So.
He got too much speed.
Because again, Cotto can still punch too.
Yeah, but he won't be able to. You can't hit. What did Ali say? Your hands can't hit. Well, your eyes can't see.
Yeah, but his eyes can see that. He'll hit.
I don't think so.
He'll land on Khan.
That's
just
a great
everybody
fight.
Was just marveling over the fight against Alexander, where Alexander didn't do that much, and then he saw Khan's face after the fight and realized he got hit a lot, you know?
So, but it didn't affect him. Maybe from his own block.
It's a guy that doesn't punch. And again, that ain't going to happen.
All right, we'll stay tuned. We'll see what happens right here. Outlaws Boxing, Coach Dion, FeasibleReport.com, and Melissa Back Reporting.